Welcome to another edition of In This House Who Tolerate Dragon Quest.
Very strange question of your impact tolerating.
Well, from what it sounds like, we're very close to getting a new party member. So, I'm trying to remember what his name was.
Angelo.
Okay. Oh, that's right. We did some grinding last time. If I recall. There was a specific route I had to take. Hey, Kane.
Morning, Kane. Yep, to the left.
Oh, hot pockets.
They're in fact hot.
No. Oh. There we go. There we go. So we're on the road to figure out what's going on with the Knights Templar.
Yeah.
Generally, those tend to be a higher level enemy anyway.
Yeah.
See, that's what I love about this map. It's just like, oh, cool, there's something down there. Can we get there? I guess we'll find out. Nah, I guess not. Oh, well.
It's not gonna matter for the slimes.
Yeah, right.
I think he was. It says the wrong targets.
Oh no, I says the she slimes.
I know. They were gonna die.
Yeah.
They're just slimes.
I know, but it's the principle of the thing.
Look, my gremlin RPG brain's always thinking, like, you know, it's like, work on these guys, do this or that.
Yeah, I mean, the problem with Sids, though, is it's not very effective against the Dingalings. Like, Crack does great, but Crack's only, like, one enemy, right? But, you know, once we start pumping it full of the right skill levels, then that'll help a bit, I think.
Yeah.
Oh. Well done.
Yes, indeed. Well, then.
Well, then.
Oh. Sorry.
No worries.
That knight added to the temple of truth. Someone who looks like Dolmag is in the abbot right now. He didn't say he was going to the abbot of Francisco. He can't stand it doing nothing. Sounds like you can't get the abbot keys to the house in the front path. But the Angela said there's like a single passage to get around, right? You know, from the ruins you were talking about, where the old rabbit was. Follow the riverbank along the back. It's all the way to the entrance to the single passageway, he said. 12 ruins upstream. Stone marker. Yep, this has gotta be the place. Look! That crest carved from a stone marker, same as the one with the ring. Closer look. Have a closer look.
The ancient stone marker is inscribed with some kind of crest. The crest appears to be the same as that on Angelo's ring. There appears to be a hole for inserting the ring. Yep.
Third it, Zap.
Skunch pushes the Templar's ring into an impression in the stone marker.
Ooh. Now how'd they hide that?
Yeah. It reveals some steps leading down into the darkness.
I attack the darkness.
Slice that thing right enough. Yeah, like, I wonder how these decisions went down at, like, in the Japanese offices, right?
Like what?
You know, like the, well, we know, you know, it's all about tradition, but could you perhaps do this thing with the interface or, like, yeah.
I think at this point they had to figure out how to make this more appealing to North Americans.
Yeah.
Gotten used to, more simplicity, I guess.
Well, I wouldn't say
simplicity. The thing was, I guess they were still thinking of us as, like, you know, the Final Fantasy II thing of, like, make it easier for them, you know?
Yeah, maybe. That and, like, it's, like, the same interface it has been since, you know, Dragon Quest V. So they were like, yeah, we can probably tighten that up a bit. Alright,
definitely want these things.
Attack. So these are what we got, so... Focus strike capable of occasion paralyzing.
No.
Unpredictable attack that can slay an enemy with enchants crease of. Does that increase our chance of crit, or just it can be a crit?
Get a shot.
Let's try that.
You got to lose.
No.
Nothing.
Did literally nothing. Oh boy. All right. Hey, audio.
Hello, Mr. Chapstick.
Hey, Mr. Chapstick.
I spy him. Yeah, now you can just see the whole dungeon.
Oh, isn't that grand?
Great.
Alright. What's good? Plenty more metals where that gun came from. Don't sweat it. I won't. Mine.
It's a cannon box.
Oh, he looks great!
Yeah.
I love it.
Yep, our first metal slimes.
Hey, Gub.
Ooh.
Well, that was...
Okay, heal.
Yep. Definitely heal.
More.
Ooh, a box. Ah, there we go.
After the runes.
Okay. That takes us down. Ooh, hot pockets. Hey, some classics. All right. Do sizz on you guys, I guess. Oops, we're on the skeletons. Jessica, let's see what a crack does on the skeletons.
Yeah, they're cold, dead.
Yeah, that's good. Damn, they tough.
They're skeletons.
Yeah, that's true. Alright,
have to kill them faster.
Yep. Nice. All right. Oh.
Okay, so this, like, there is actual cap based on your level. So, yeah, just put in humanity.
Can do. Oh.
Stop harder now.
Whistle. Ooh. Instagrind.
Yeah. That's the funny thing, Yangus. He peaks so early, he can actually reach that cap.
Damn. Good to know, though. Lucky. So, there's just some stuff there, so let's go down here.
That's a lot of books.
Must be some nerdlinger.
Always trying to make gold, it looks like.
Might learn a recipe or two. It's a monk's diary.
5 people died yesterday, 2 more today. The disease consumes its victims with terrifying speed. Where is it coming from? Is it being spread by humans or rats or something else? Nobody knows. Only one thing is certain, there is no cure. The plague has turned our once peaceful abbey into a living hell in the blink of an eye. Is it the goddess testing us? Or is this a punishment for our sins? I don't know. The only thing I'm sure about is that I have lost many brothers today. I will lose more tomorrow. Dear diary, the life of a monk is spartan and meager. I cannot bring myself to throw anything away, no matter how worn or worthless it may be. Yesterday I sued and all, an old and worn-out bandana to a band. Ooh. I think I have both of those things.
Yeah.
Alright. Well, we did have hot pockets, so... Oh. Okay, well, we'll do that. Hey, AJ.
Morning, AJ.
Hey, it's a jewel bag. Bag of laughs. Nice localization.
Right.
Alright, this is ain't bad. So I'm gonna heal Skunch. I'll split one of those guys.
Actually take care of the other two.
Yeah. Nice. Oh. There we go.
Chest.
Ooh.
That's gonna be an upgrade for someone.
Yeah, right. Let's see. Let's give it to
Skunch.
Yeah, he needs it. God, leather shield, no kidding. Alright.
I think I'm... Well... Yeah.
Thank you. Wait, did we go all the way down that hallway? We did not. Okay. So there might be an item down that way. Oh, good.
Yep, the door is shut tightly.
Oh boy. That's always a great sign.
Fine. Three groups of Drakimas.
Actually, once Yangus learns a multi-character attack, it's going to get very interesting.
Happen, I think.
Okay.
Well, that did it.
Yep. Oh, you little shit.
Well, that was just a wasted turn.
Yeah. There we go. So I can take us back up. Okay. There's also... That doesn't look ominous at all.
Talking about tons of coffins and piles of bones? That's normal for a church.
It's got Dragon Quest... signature Dragon Quest purple stinkiness. Oh, right. That can temporarily prevent enemies from attacking. Ah. Oh, it actually damages them. Interesting. Go down here, it'll take us here.
Bumby boy.
I love it. Oops. This was me, Sizz. back to town. So we can get our MP back and then tackle this fresh.
Warp out, warp back.
Good idea.
I do.
Nearest place is... Oh, cool. Ruined Abbey, so it doesn't matter where we go.
Yeah. Maybe we should try that recipe for the bandana.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Also, you know.
Cheeky save, yeah. I was thinking about that. So it's how can we call it?
The bandana and a grass skirt.
Yep. No, wait. Oh, crap. There we go. Oh. Very good, sir. Okay.
Yes, sir. But yeah, you can make an early profit if you go and sell, like, certain things.
Yeah. I suppose so. I guess that's
it's a way. It's a way of like infinite money, technically.
Yeah, I wonder if it's like one of those like once you know that's a good like new game plus thing.
But it's more viable in the ports where alchemy's instant.
Yeah.
And you could just put a whole bunch in, get it immediately, sell it, and get that, because this one you have to wait.
We'll be right back.
He just tries to curse, and you're like, curse, Smursh.
Just, like, wipe it off.
Shit ain't nothing, right, Yangus? He's just on the ground dead.
Bleeding out of his face.
That's curse coming out of his mouth.
I had curse for breakfast, dear.
Oh, it's like the worst hangover it is.
It takes skill to be flying while you're asleep.
Yep.
We don't take none of that funny business here. Let's see, I wanted to go down the steps. Down that long corridor.
One of the things I love watching is, Pokemon stuff that's not related to the games.
Like that, the Chinese New Year one.
Yeah.
It's very, I love how they,
I love when they do slice of life.
They make it very much feel like it's a world you want to be in.
They've gotten really good at, like, just the slice of life when it's not, like, okay. When it's not Pokemon battling or anything.
Dude stuck in car with his Psyduck.
And yeah, the scene where like she wants to like, Dad, this is my boyfriend. And he has the intimidating Pokemon. Cause you know it's like that's like bringing the shotgun out.
Yeah, I love it.
No, they got like very good at portraying the slice of life, which is what people really really like. On the opposite end, I found the worst thing that Pokemon's ever done last night.
Tell me.
You know
more.
That Pokemon tried to be in newspaper comics?
Oh.
But no, it's worse than that. It's better than, but not as bad, as good as like Foxyponus.
Yeah. Dang, yo. Thanks for the gift subs. Hey, Captain Wacky, enjoy your subs. Very cool of you, Fox Famous.
Hello, hello.
So you're saying that they were doing a...
They wanted to do a... So, this is when Charles Schultz was dying.
Uh-huh.
And was going to leave this big, big space in newspapers, and the Pokemon Company wanted to take advantage of that and try and get, like, take the peanut spot. So they hired, the writer who's done, like, lots of, like, video game stuff.
Uh-huh.
And the artist who's also done, like, all the Nintendo Power, like, all the Nintendo Power comics. And he's very, very eccentric, is that he wears full-body leopard, jumpsuits. Spotted jumpsuits that are sparkly. And these comics were supposed to appeal more to, like, more mature, and in the end, trying to put Pokemon humor with more mature stuff for an American audience. So boring. Not funny.
I mean, that's American newspaper comics for you.
Because it was more, Ash's mom was more the main character. Mm. And just how she's just like, oh, those darn Pokemon.
It's like, do you follow, like, that account that just tweets the latest Heathcliff comic?
Oh, I've seen.
Just absolute nonsensical jokes? Like, it's just sort of like a statement than a joke. Children love the meat tank. So I'm just figuring out coffee here. Yum, yum, yum.
Yeah, I lasted 6 months, never got more run, and it was just
Eh. And while I'm on the subject of comics, I was also looking at, I was looking at Ninja Turtles stuff yesterday, and, boy, oh boy. I remember when, they had, oh, man. Oh, mouse line. I was looking at the Archie's, comics thing, and I was remembering Ninjara.
Oh.
The female fox, the female fox ninja was more or less, like, one of the writer's OCs.
Yep.
I'm and saying... how she ends up, like, falling in love with, like, she falls in love with, Raphael.
That's what happens when you get pendered.
No, it gets... No, they definitely did get pendered because eventually, like, she gets written out of the comic and that she finds a mate and just leaves, Raphael. It's like... And then... He took her and tried to continue more stories in an adult furry card comic. In fact, at the end, like, the advertisement for was, she's not hanging around teenagers anymore. Jeez. And immediately, it was filled with boobs and violence and swearing. And lasted 3 issues.
It also doesn't help that it was also Archie Comics. That the, this sort of thing happened at.
Yeah. And now Viacom owns the rights to her, so they can't, like, continue using anything with her.
Yeah.
But she did appear, like, in the New Turtles game, in one of the background.
Cool.
Because they tried to start incorporate the Archie comic characters, because, like, they were still really good characters.
I guess it also depends on, like, who owns those.
Yeah.
If they're, like, separate from the Nickelodeon license, are they, like... Yeah.
I just love... Oh, hey, Ninjara's back! With boobs! I think the first time she reappeared was, there was, like, a 30th anniversary thing, and, like, So Mirage was, like, the original, like, company that did the Ninja Turtles.
Yeah.
They did, like, a 30th anniversary thing, and they got the original artist from the Archie comics back, because he probably did, like, the best Turtles art for Archie. And he, like, it's... The whole comic was, like, Rocksteady and Bebop come back from the planet where there's nothing full of animals, and they're just... naked there. They come back to Earth and they try to get food. And the turtles think that they're just being bad guys and they're not. And then Raph and Ninjara appear and Raph's being Raph. A piece of shit. And Ninjara's just there.
And Ninjara's there.
And now they're gone. I laugh because I remember, like, they tried the Archie comics tried to do the thing with, like, make another team, the Mighty Mutimals, which were these other mutants, Waterweed Mold. Hmm. You know, maybe some mold on some cheese would do something.
God damn it. Well, we gotta wait for this current set of Hot Pockets to finish, so.
But yeah, like, the Mighty Mutimals was like, Leatherhead, this Ray, like, Manta Ray guy, Mondo Gecko, this Jaguar guy. And they were gonna have, like, they were gonna work on, like, an alternate TV series with them. Mighty Mutimals. And instead, it didn't work out, so they killed them off in the comic.
Jeez. What a waste.
And then the new comic guy made their own team.
Oh, what a fine-looking fellow. Yep, that's the guy.
Then you got your MP. Top off.
Oh boy, oh boy.
Dang it. Go on.
Well, I understand the current run with IDW has been a good series. IDW tends to do good comics anyways. They do the current Sonic one. In America.
Yeah, I guess they picked... I wonder if they just sort of picked up that from Archie the same time they picked up Sonic.
Well, no, because after Archie ended, it's like Mirage is still doing their own comic.
Okay.
I think it's when Nickelodeon got the rights to it. Remember, Nickelodeon just got the Turtles in the 2000s. 2010. Because the Archie comic ended in, like, the 90s. It lasted a while, though.
Oh, that Jughead.
He's so dreamy and asexual. Except for in the show, but the but that show was on crack, literally on crack.
Yeah. That's so stupid.
And I thought, like, me watching season one, wow, this is so boring. Just generic and boring, and me not watching season two and realizing, oh, this is gonna go on cocaine and crack. Crack cocaine, but.
Hey!
Scrunchie leveled up!
Intrepid. Holy protection.
Ooh, that was a really good level for her.
Yeah. Since we... Let's put it into staves, because we put it into sexiness last time.
Yeah. We really need to get our stave.
Yeah. Speaking of things we really need to do. Thanks to that fight. Holy protection. Generates a holy aura that causes weaker monsters to avoid. Oh! Okay.
Holy water.
Yeah. Whatever.
I really need to read the new Sonic comic from Archie. Or from IDW.
Sir. Do you know how to get out of here?
Plague. So much pain, so much sorrow. Why does my goddess remain silent? How much long? How long must I languish in misery? Who served you so faithfully, yet we died in agony? A terrible plague consumed my beautiful abbey. Oh, the memory, the pain, so much pain. Now you shall taste for a moment the agony I have endured for an eternity, but fear not, for you shall be saved by the blissful peace of death.
Last time. Tortured soul.
So we're gonna have you psych up, Genghis psych up, spells.
It's Sizzle.
So we've basically taken him down to his maximum, his maximum debuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, licensing the staff, so she works in HR. Yeah, you could say that.
Yeah.
Ba-da-ba-ba-da-ba.
I think it's a good call for healing. Well, nah, I think it's fine. You gotta love your main heroes in these games. You're a Swiss Army knife of usefulness, okay, but you're only using the syringe because it heals.
Yep.
Oh, back up.
This complicates things.
Should probably do more damage. Does a little damage too.
Yep.
Nice.
Jessica, Psycho. Heal Yangus next round. I'll take poisoned.
Forget you have like healing items, yeah. I think those heal around like 50, so that'll take care of it.
There we go.
You know, nothing like two crits. Yeah, later bosses, you're gonna be like, psyching up many times.
Thank you. There we go.
Hey, not bad.
Yeah.
Oh my goddess, my dear sweet goddess. At last I shall rest cradled in your blessed arms and your bazongas.
Your bosoms, if you would.
I mean your boobs.
Hey. Oh. I'll take that.
That was nice.
Thank you, game. Very cool of you.
We should check out that statue after the break.
We still got a couple minutes. That's at least... I don't think we can check out the statue, though.
Okay.
Yeah, no, it's just... So he just gets this in the corridor. Oh, fuck.
You're still poisoned, aren't you?
Yeah.
Well, at least you got full MP, so you can do that. Well.
The boy.
The baby. Hey, you get free turns, so... use hatchet, like, the good attack.
Okay.
Hatchet man.
Okay, good, he's in it for another round.
Flies.
Oh! Come on. Okay, still out for another round. Good. Yeah, eat shit. Okay. Metal slime scene. Come closer. Yes!
Oh, it only did one damage.
It's all it needed. That's, you know, metal slime.
So, okay, so that's an instant death hit.
Yeah.
It's not the crit, because the crit's different.
So I'm guessing that doesn't work on bosses, then.
Yeah. But let me double check. Well, there you go. Boy. I should just put it all in humanity, this level.
Well, I think that's probably... yeah.
You're gonna get, like, nothing in this.
Kind-hearted, learned he... yeah!
Yep. Now he actually has to use for his MP.
But yeah, let's continue this after a break. So we're gonna run some ads for a few minutes, and we'll be back with more Dragon Quest.
Good show.
And we're back.
Yo.
So would you say Dark Cloud is worth getting into?
I never played it, but I've heard nothing but great things about it.
Okay. Because that was...
I think it's on the PS... Yeah, it was pretty much their first game.
Yeah.
But yeah, people love Dark Cloud 1, too.
Okay.
I think it's on PS4, Dark Cloud 1.
Mini Metal.
Not that, it's part of the collection. Can't use the wagon, you're not there. You're in town.
Ooga booga.
Oh hey, they're knocked out.
Oh, that's a great sign.
Somebody save the abbot.
Oh great, it's up to Muggins.
Party chat.
Good call.
Oh, Maggis must be inside. Now we got him.
I knew it. Dole Magus is here. Dad, we gotta stop before he hurts anyone else.
It's up to...
How convenient they're knocked out the second that we get past the dungeon. Oh my. But first, man, there's some books here. A lot of books.
Who is he, that jester? The abbot. Someone please save.
Yeah, don't mind. Just gonna... There are many books related to the church and religion here, including A History of Mile Abbey, Chanting Made Easy, and Passage to Neos. Okay. There's a book entitled Puns, The Fire of My Youth. It seems to have been written by Abbot Francisco. Ever since I was a young lad, nothing has excited me so much as the creation of puns. I created a training regimen by challenging myself to come up with 5 new gags and 10 new puns every day. This book is the fruit of my efforts. It represents my comedic blood, sweat, and tears. Skunch flicked through the pages of Abbot Francisco's bad jokes with a chuckle and quietly aww. Bless. He, that jester, seemed to be acting normally when he first arrived. Then he suddenly went mad, started laughing hysterically, and ran off up to the Holy Father's chamber. I tried to stop him, but even the three of us. Can I do that shelf? Oh, okay. A guy walks into a bar. Ouch! Francisco. P.S. I deserve a feather in my cap for that one. I love it. He just really likes bad jokes. Okay.
Yeah.
What do you call a fish with no eyes? Fish. What's this guy?
So bad.
8 loves reading error manga. Hey, Waki.
Couldn't stop him, he's...
That's what they call the hero, 8.
Oh, okay. See if there are any more of these. Nope, alright. A bit of levity before story, I guess.
Hello.
Oh, he's finally
seen.
Well then. Well, he's dead. What's his desk?
What sinister presence lingers in the air? And
God
who
damn
are
it,
you?
Zap.
Did you want to speak with me?
Uh,
There they are!
It's them! You'll be damned for trying to take Abbot Francisco's life!
What on earth? What's going on?
Bother.
Yes, quite.
Abbot Francisco, Captain Marcello, at your service, as always.
Ah, Marcello. Tell me, what's happening?
Bruv.
There has been a breach of security. Many of the guards have been seriously wounded.
What?
I feared you might be in danger, so I came immediately. And sure enough, we've caught these criminals. They've been loitering around the Abbey since midday. It seems we were just in time. I thank the goddess that you're safe.
Wait, these people are no criminals.
Please, Holy Father, they were caught red-handed.
Look into their eyes. See their pure hearts. These people are guilty of nothing.
But...
I don't like them!
But we must find out what they were doing here in your residence so late at night. At the very least, let us ascertain that. Please.
The worst possible crime, the guilt of nothing, yeah.
You really are a warrior, Marcello. Very well, if you must.
Thank you, Holy Father. So, shall we go?
Douche.
Huh. So funny enough, looking at all the different Turtles comics, Fleetway had their hand in a Turtles comic too.
Huh. I do.
Yeah. So yeah, not only did like
we ain't done nothing
Archie
wrong.
Had like the same like Turtles and Sonic, so did Fleetway.
Yeah, we told you. It was your man who asked us to check up on the abbot. What right have you to keep us here?
The abbot is too forgiving. If you're innocent, then who attacked my men? I, on the other hand, am not so forgiving. You won't fool me, so don't try. You're confessing... Who is it?
Candygram. Candygram from Mongo.
You sent for me, Captain.
Come in. I have a question to ask you, but there's something else first. We've just arrested these intruders in the abbot's residence. They were attempting to take his life. They wounded 6 of my men. Very well. The problem is this. My guard is watertight. I make sure of that. There's no way for an outsider to get inside the Abbey. Unless, of course, they have inside help.
Yeah, fancy that.
And would you believe it? When we searched their possessions, we found this ring. Templar Angelo, where is your ring? Show it to me now, if you have it.
Punch him.
It's turned up. Thank the goddess.
Just look at that.
Love it.
Someone stole it from me at the pub. And it looks like they're about to learn that crime doesn't pay.
Stole it? What? You little fibber.
We've no use for a ring like that. He set us up. I should have known better than to believe a single word from the mouth of a filthy cheat like you.
Once again, I just love the dumb look on your face.
Yeah. He's just like,
you can find me in my chambers.
If you try and say something, you know she's gonna kick you in the shins.
Yeah.
Like, right, 8?
Wait!
Right, Skunch?
We're not done here.
You know, in the very last Dragon Quest game, they're gonna have the hero say something.
Fine.
I honestly don't know. Later.
Like, it'll be
first
the last
things
line.
First. You've wasted enough of my time. Don't try my patience. I want answers. What did you plan to do to the abbot?
How many times have we got to tell you, eh? We ain't got nothing to confess!
What is it now?
We found a suspicious monster loitering outside the abbey.
What? What kind of monster?
Ouch!
God damn it.
What the devil do you think you're doing?
Hey, Trode.
Yoo-hoo! Yengus, Jessica! What are you all doing in here? You were gone for such a long time, I was getting rather worried. So I just decided to come and look for you when this...
So, this monster is a friend of yours, then? So much for your pure hearts.
Cool. You're obviously evil.
He's racist. Don't like that.
What's wrong with you? Unhand me at once, you insolent ruffian! Get him off me!
You are in league with the monster. You may have deceived Abbot Francisco, but you don't fool me. It was the monster who ordered you to steal the ring and infiltrate the abbey, was it? You cursed heathens. Thought you could scare people by killing the abbot, did you? Make them question their faith? And then move in and take control, I suppose. Take these monstrosities to the cells. Come dawn tomorrow, I will have you tortured. Perhaps then you will realize the gravity of the sins you have committed. Until sunrise, then. Sleep well.
Whoop.
There's no point screaming. Can't use our heads to get out of the cell. Can't you think of anything, Skunch?
Slow blink.
I'm no monster! I'm a king! Blast every one of those Templar twerps!
The twerps and MD.
The problem is, he constantly like, but I'm a king and I need to act like a king. I'm... Because he doesn't realize, like, oh, monsters, like, you're still a fucking monster. I'm a king. Oh, what a blade nerve. We ain't gotten done nothing. Let us out of here. No, you can't just back out.
Damn.
Keep talking to people, or wait.
Shh! Someone's coming.
Good evening, everyone. Glad to see you're all looking so well.
Come here, you!
Now, control your temper. I must apologize for before. Perhaps you will accept this as conciliation.
What are you up to?
The guard upstairs might hear if we talk now. I'll explain later. Come on.
Jailbreak.
Follow me. The guard's up ahead. Right, no one make a sound, okay? I seasoned his supper with a generous pinch of sleeping powder. Perfect. It worked. Sleeping like a baby. Okay, through here. Right, we're safe in here. You can talk again now.
Good! Tell us what's going on. What ordeal do you intend to put us through next, hmm?
Like I said, I'm sorry about before. If I hadn't lied about the ring, Marcello would have been onto me like a shot. And I haven't got anywhere else to go if I'm chucked out of here. But I came to get you out, didn't I? Come on, don't be angry. Anyway, let me show you something you won't have seen before.
Well, what is it?
I like how people just grab with one hand.
There. And that's real blood on those spikes, you know. If I were to throw you in there and shut the door, your whole body would be skewered. I could make you holier than thou without so much as getting my hands dirty. Not bad, eh?
Well, he's dead. Once again, I just love seeing the reactions, you know?
Yeah.
Can you hear me out there? There's a secret passage in here!
Like I said, not bad, eh?
The first game where you can really get, like, really, really get a feel for your party.
Yeah.
Hang around here for too long. Look, has me helping you escape. Let's move. Oh.
Smashies.
Alright, nope. Give us something. Come on. Get in there. That's a spirit.
What's your game, eh? First you grass on us for something we ain't done, and then you come and help us.
Sorry if I've confused you. The people here have a bit of a trust issue with me. I couldn't stick up for you before. It would have backfired. The man who interrogated you, Marcello.
He's a dick.
Him. That's why I had to let him put you in the cells before I could help you.
That's all well and good, but you still don't know us from Adam. Ain't you worried about us being friends with this old monster, eh? You're just happy to let us go, are ya?
True, I don't know anything about you. And I wasn't there when you were caught, but I do know you saved the abbot's life, because just before you were brought to the interrogation room, the sinister feeling that's been lingering in the air went away. I must thank you for that. I'm not so ruthless that I'd hang you out to dry. And besides, I couldn't stand by while there was a lady in trouble. Marcello's a rather talented inquisitor, you know. This leads outside.
Where are you?
I knew it. Yes! The stable, of course.
What about horse princesses?
Horse princess. Do. Fucking knew it.
Medea! My Medea! You're safe. Were you lonely without me? There.
You just push her out of the way, and he's like, where's the alchemy pot?
Leave this horrible place.
Gotta make things.
Once.
Also, I have a recipe, because...
The princess...
I'll tell you a nice recipe
ahead.
For a better weapon.
Make sure you're not too far behind.
Princess? Whatever. Come on, let's go. You'd have to work
Don't
pretty hard
it.
To mess up your escape from here. Anyway, I'm sorry for all the trouble. So, this is farewell. May the goddess watch over you on your journey.
Until I join your party later on.
Yeah.
He's got main character energy.
Oh, totally. Now, I'm just wearing this because... Just because.
Well...
Oh my.
Oh, so nobody can get to the abbot.
Is the whole abbey on fire? Surely that jester didn't come back again. Oh no. I've got to save the abbot.
Oh, stay with us.
No, we are. Okay.
Right. Pod first. We'll talk first.
No, Magus pissed off a fixation with fire. He burnt down Master Vlice's house when he attacked him. Bound to be him who set fire to the bridge, blast at Lonesome Chester. For goodness sake, what are you dithering around here for? Hurry up and go after that Angelo chap.
Maybe better we just let Jessica back to Alexandria, eh, Gov? I mean, she got guts and all that. The old Magus ain't messing around. Getting cut out for this sort of thing, if you ask me. Should be dolled up in a nice frock, sipping tea, and not fighting monsters. Magus is probably with Abbot Francisco as we speak. It hurt the Abbey.
I'm not sure if you got a recipe for this, or if you do, but you do have the ingredients, so I'll just tell you now. First, what do we get? I hate it. Yeah, extremely rare. But let me tell you how to make something good. You have an extra boomerang, right?
Yes.
Use that, and there's only one other use for the iron nails. Besides making the thief key, and it's making a better boomerang. This will get you a nice little upgrade.
Yes.
Like, I checked, there's no other use for iron nails. Spoiler, but at this point, eh.
Nope.
Typically when I'm, like, when I'm attacking, I always have a Yangus attack the last enemy because they're gonna take the least amount of damage from AoEs. And he can usually just finish them off. That's what Yangus is good for, getting that last hit in.
Oh, absolutely. To the Abbey again.
Again, even though we literally just left this.
Have you heard some traveler went and set fire to the Abbey? He wasn't from around here, of course.
I'm going on a trip to buy some stock, so I thought I'd come and prove safe passage. This isn't exactly a good start, is it?
Talking about this is a good sign.
Yeah, do not panic. It's just a small fire in the kitchen. We'll soon have it out. See the flames from Simpleton. I hope Angela's alright. What brings you to what? Might as well.
You have enough to get a staff for her, by the way, after this.
Oh, yeah.
She's like 1500, so.
Oh man, Time Extension have an article about the making of Sorcerian. I'm gonna have to read that later. That one's always interested me. Like, it's not my kind of RPG, but it's just something about it is really interesting.
Right.
I was laughing what happened with Mello in Cult of the Lamb last night.
Oh, yeah?
Two characters, like, made a baby.
Mm-hmm.
And immediately one of them dies right afterwards. I watched Bryce play some Persona 3 remake. Good.
The bridge, it's going to collapse. We've got to get across the island before it goes down in flames. Stop wasting time, you cowards.
Alright. You could say something.
God, you guys suck. Just run across him. God.
Dum-dums.
Damn! Where's Marcel? Huh? That sinister presence again. No, not sinister. It's worse than that.
It's stinky.
It's pure evil. As if all the demons of hell had gathered to feast Abbot Francisco!
Anime run! Yeah, I mean, we ran across the bridge too. Just saying.
Nearly as cool as his.
It's locked from the inside. Marcello? Are you in there? Damn! What's going on? It's no good! It won't budge. Yulon, did you follow me here?
Slow blink.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
I need your help. Just one last time, all right? We're going to have to do this by brute force. There might just be enough of us. The door's locked from the inside. We've got to break it down. Come on,
Nice.
Yes!
Yes, more
what
like
happened? Yarned. Come on, tell. Stay with it. Tell me what happened.
Thank the goddess, you've come. Help the Abu.
The Abu?
Buonup did this.
He's dangerous. Captain Marcello is in trouble.
Alas. Upstairs. Come on, let's go. Whippy, right?
Man, like the animation.
Yeah.
It's great.
It's just, I will save the abbot, Gurg.
Oh, you're back.
Marcello!
Damn, my organs!
It was all that jester. I couldn't stop him. He's strong. But you can't let him. This is an order. Templar Angelo, get the abbot to safety.
Oh, my organs.
Now nothing stands in my way.
You dare lay a finger on Abbot Francisco?
Don't worry, Marcello. I will be fine. I have given myself to the goddess. If it is her wish, I am prepared to die. But... wretched sinner, if that is not her wish, nothing you can do will ever harm me.
He's gonna die horribly.
The goddess will protect us all from whatever evil you can muster.
The power of Christ compels you.
You have. Let's put it to the test, shall we?
Wait! Cor blimey!
Second Cor blimey.
It's been a while, Duel Magus.
Ah, if it isn't King Toad, looking as small and ugly as ever.
Shut up! Return my daughter and I to normal at once! Do you realize what you've done to my castle?
Oh, cool. That's a good shot.
Oh. Well.
What?
Turns out the goddess wanted me to die after all.
Such a pity. It seems fate and your benevolent goddess are both on my side.
You can tell I'm powerful because of the PS2 blend frame mode is on.
Yes, such a pity. Poor Francisco. My work here is done!
Peace, bitches! It'll make us out!
Is such sweet sorrow!
Like Snax's thing on one of the pits broken glass. Ah, crap! Left my staff in poor Francisco. Nice.
Following day, under a heavy cloud of rain, Abbot Francisco's body was committed to the ground.
It's that.
Happy birthday to the ground. Meanwhile, Domenica slipped away into the darkness once again. Marcello somehow managed to escape injury, explained to everyone the events of the previous night, and that he was a craven douche. Scunch and the party were cleared of any suspicion, but he never apologized. Everyone at the funeral felt a terrible sorrow at the loss of the abbot, and the heavens, too, wept tears of grief.
So sad.
Amazing Grace on melodica.
The rain continued until dawn, the start of a new day.
Oh, it didn't even do the New Day thing. Hmm.
Yeah, it was that sad.
I would love for them to have like a minor key version of that.
No.
Yeah, like a, it's a new day, but it's not a good day.
Ah, you're awake. I realize I said it before the funeral, but I just wanted to assure you that everyone knows you're innocent. If it weren't for you, Captain Marcello could well have been killed too. We're all in your debt. Anyway, the Templar Captain has summoned you to his office. See you later then. Don't forget.
You're definitely not suspected of any crime. Wink.
I couldn't sleep at all last night. Ah, cursed Omegas.
Oh, the governor looks like Dolmagus gives the slip again, eh? Oh, and people dead. I can't believe it.
Press F, yeah.
Their injuries are very serious, but everyone seems to be showing signs of recovery. They should all live, except for Larry.
Still can't believe Abbot Francisco's gone. Kill that jester, he won't give you.
I'm sorry that you were destined on a false charge. Oh, I pray for you, Holy Father.
Oh, you. Captain's been waiting for you. Hurry up.
God.
Sec. Don't mind me. Just
tradition.
Just tradition. Just, it's just walking around. It's a book written by Abbot Francisco.
It says, do not combine a band of grass skirt and a bandana together.
Yeah. Centuries ago, individuals called great sages walked the earth, serving as guides and mentors for the people of the world. According to legend, each of these great sages wore a garment called the sage's robe. Ooh.
Know how to make it?
Magical robe with a scholar's cap.
That sounds pretty high level.
Yeah.
But we have it, a magical garment and a scholar's cap.
Well, we have a magical piece of leather, right?
No, like we need a magical robe.
Yeah.
Like a magic vestment. Magic beast leather is just leather. I'm not sure if it's better for Yangus or worse. Way, way worse.
I'm sure it might be used in a feature recipe, though. Let's...
maybe.
We'll see. It's spring issue of We Love Our Weapons. Who doesn't love the boom... ah!
Ah, there we go. Well, I saved you like 5-10 minutes.
There we go. Pointy object, there we go.
Yeah. Something pointy, I wonder.
See, I like that. It doesn't just straight up spell it out to you.
Yeah.
This is a good system.
It is.
There you are. I trust you slept well. King Trode has explained everything. I apologize for having doubted you.
And for being such a weenus.
Dulmagus is the true culprit. In the name of the goddess, we must strike down that diabolical jester.
And in the name, and in we, I mean you guys.
But I cannot leave now. As the new abbot, I have much to do. I must be here to guide my people. So, I was wondering, according to what King Trode tells me, you are all pursuing Dulmagus. So I have a proposal. I would like my brother Angelo to accompany you on your quest.
Brother? I thought you said you wouldn't have a rule breaker as a brother.
Quiet! I wasn't talking to you.
Angelo.
This doesn't concern you. It very much concerns me.
Yeah.
Everyone else here has duties to fulfill. Only you are without such responsibilities.
I'm useless, you mean?
Mm.
No need to beat about the bush. Fine, I understand. You've made yourself perfectly clear. I will leave the Abbey. I will travel with these people. And I will avenge the Abbot's murder.
I'll be waiting by the carriage with Medea, then.
This is a map of the world.
Yeah!
If you're going to catch Duel Magus, I'm sure you'll find it indispensable. Consider it a peace offering for having doubted you and your friends. Please.
Finally.
Very well then. I entrust Angelo to your care and wish you well on your journey.
Well, got Angelo now. Yeah. Follow what was said before, but our kids can come along with us. Think with all of us. Yeah. Might be with a shot against Dormey with four of us. Alright, sweet. Nice. Diamond. So fire it up now, girl. Ready for action. I'd believe those two are brothers. Nothing alike. Apart from the way they annoy me every time they open their mouths, in that respect, they're identical twins. Whatever. My equal's right, they say. Happy to take whatever help we can get. The extra pair of hands, it's time to look up again. Let's find Omega's and cut down the size.
Solo said the death of the abbot and the fire were both work that eerie jester is here before. Why would anyone do such awful things? Don't think we've got anything we can really do in there, so.
Get on with it.
It's adventure. Next story beat, please.
Hello again. Well, it looks like we'll be seeing a lot more of each other. I hope you don't mind me coming along. I'm not doing this because Marcello ordered me to. I'm doing it for Abbot Francisco. He was like a father to me. That jester, Duel Magus. He can't get away with this. And this place. I'll be glad to escape. It's no hardship being asked to join you, believe me. And anyway, I promised you, didn't I? I said I'd reward you for helping me.
Jessica's just like, oh, sorry, threw up in my mouth a little.
So, Jessica, from now on, I'll protect you.
Ugh.
I won't leave your side. Consider me your personal bodyguard.
Okay, just throws him in front of, like, the biggest monsters.
Sure, Romeo. In your dreams.
Angelo joined the party.
Hey, and now we are four.
Now we have a dashing Templar knight off with us.
An exemplar knight.
Okay, let's hit the road.
Welcome aboard, Trunks. I mean,
yeah.
So right. Let's check out our new party member.
Yeah. Oops. Attributes, there we go.
So he can use swords? A brand new weapon, bows. And staves.
Staves.
And charisma.
Charisma. That's gonna be some interesting reason. Skills, I'm sure.
So if we look at, let's look at it as like a skill magic set. So, I'll tell you now, he's gonna be your healer.
Okay.
He can finally give Skun to rest.
He's got buff.
Cause he's basically a priest or pilgrim.
Okay.
And I'm just gonna tell you now, his best weapon is bows.
Cool.
Swords kind of make him like a weaker version of you. Staves is nice, but bows are really, really, really good. We have an extra shield we... Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God, it's so big.
Yeah.
So
We have extra shield we can give Angelo.
Oh.
There you go. So it's really easy to scout a whole region now.
Oh, cool!
Yeah!
Oh my god, that's so cool!
This world map's really, really helpful.
I guess we should...
Well, well, so Angela joined the ranks. My retainers now, too.
Hey, I'm just coming along for the ride for a while. Not to have to pledge my service to monsters.
What impudence! You're even more uncouth than that oaf Yangus! Being in your sorry company makes me look a little more dignified.
Wait a minute, Granddad?
Oh, it was about time I left the Abbey, really. Lots of big rules and regulations, not enough fun for my liking. I'm mind getting to know the delightful Jessica more intimately, too. Of course, there's that business of venting the Abbot's death. I need to learn about her, tracts of land, if you would.
Oops. You know, apart from the Abbot, there's also a big town and the castle of this continent. They're all far, they're all way away, my opinion. We should get some shut at the inn before we get going. Get going or get Gavin. Still plenty of places we have to explore on this continent. The Omegas must be here somewhere. No, Skunch. Not just Alice's death that needs to be avenged. It's all the hands of all the everyone that Delmagus murdered. Got to stop him, for all of us sakes. Yeah, there's other stuff on this, to go to the town first.
Yeah, go to Simpleton.
Let's get that mage staff for Jessica.
Right.
And see if we can... We actually have a decent amount of money right now. You can get some upgrades.
Hold on. So... Who's
I just said just walk. Simpleton.
Oh, right. You know what? While we're on the way to Simpleton...
I just walk.
That was that monster.
Okay.
Alright, so you got the smooth loosh.
And buff. So he's got decent damage, but he's not gonna hit as hard as Gunch or Yangus. But he does free up, he can do the healing work now, so Skunk can do more damage.
Cool.
Yep.
Right.
But yeah. You want to get hit bows, because like the second thing he gets from bows immediately makes him like amazing.
Sweet.
I could say what, but... Get something really, really good.
Here with the chunky dragon. I'm fine with that. Hello. Hey, that's
a
game.
Knight.
Okay, so we're gonna have you psych up.
I'm laughing, I'm looking at this, like, under the Calgary Game Collectors. This is definitely a listing. Chrono Trigger wrong cover sticker. $10. Repo Chrono Trigger for SNES. Has Donkey Kong sticker on it instead, though.
Jeez.
Like, either way.
Yeah.
This is a bad pun. It's a picture of, like, Jesus Christ looking up at a clock. Jesus Christ, look at the time.
God.
Right.
Does Scunch have a
sword? No, he's... Not yet. But to be fair, we're gonna give him a better weapon. Got the boomerang. Our only sword's probably like that crap, like that other sword that's weaker than the boomerang. That was decent damage.
Yeah. Alright, that was fun.
Put that as a little mold.
Make some blue cheese, baby.
This cheese doing battle, though.
Hmm.
Deal?
Maybe.
Let's try out when we get it. Yeah, new boomerang. We don't have it. Oh, there we go. There you go, thanks, Gerb. Whoosh. You know, I guess it's an okay name from Hellwind. Yeah, sadly, wind damage always sucks. Kind of a marked improvement.
Yeah. Actually, I'm gonna put that in the bag.
Okay, the attack went up by like 13 from the normal boomerang, so that'll last you a bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, still, Sconch is still in the position where he can use whatever weapon, not tied down to one. Yeah, she's barely doing any damage with the whip.
Ah, yeah.
Whips are amazing, though, in this game, but you have to really invest in them. Get her this and 20 MP. Might have to sleep at the end because it's gonna get the MP.
Yep.
So, yeah, you gotta make sure, like, Yangus has access, even if, like, the sledgehammer is stronger. not going to be as good because he can't use the skills.
Yeah.
Yeah, look at that big increase in MP.
Damn.
Yeah. You know what? We should go to the inn during the break.
We should. So we're going to take a few minute break, and we'll be back with more Dragon Quest.
Good show.
Good show. And we're back.
Yep.
So, I like that the game has basically gone, well, get at it. So now we're getting at it.
Get going or get Gavin.
Thank you. Oh, that's cool.
Actually, don't. You have her staff.
All right.
A wizard staff. That can just cast Frizz for free. Plus, her attack's a bit higher now, so. Well, not as nearly as good as you guys, but. And it's still small enough that she has a free hand.
Until we get a ship, I imagine.
There it is. The I in team, hidden in the A-hole. Spotted in Essex. I tried donating blood. Never again. Too many stupid questions. Whose blood is it? Where did you get it from? Why is it in a bucket? Fencing, the perfect COVID sport. Mask, glove. Stab anyone who gets closer than 6 feet.
That's nice.
The Grinch never hated Christmas. He hated people, which is fair. Let me look at Jessica real quick. Let me look at... Ooh, nice. Let me see how close she is to anything, okay?
Okay.
Get the 21 staves. Then, yeah. Magic staffer. You're a magic bounce.
Those around Jessica start to realize just how sexy she can be. Some monsters ought to begin. Oh, jeez.
So now, she has a 1/16 chance to charm the monsters at the start of each turn.
Ah.
So they won't attack her.
Oh, pop pocket.
So that's just good to have in general. I just love that she realizes how sexy she could be. Monsters also realize how sexy she could be.
Cool cheese. Shame you can't, like, move the...
Yeah. Line,
but it looks like we follow the path for now.
Alright. I love this. There's a bridge, and right before it, if you hit this sign, you will hit that bridge. Mr. Chapstick says, Zap going, ooh, ha, pocket, every time the Octopod dings is the funniest thing.
It's the noise of Hot Pocket being ready. Bang.
You got more impeded to cast that, so.
Nice.
The best advertising, honest advertising. Poor English, but great Oriental food. Asian buffet. Okay, this is kind of funny towards, like, it's a good towards vegans joke.
Mm-hmm.
You're vegans. I killed this cow because it was eating your food. You're welcome.
Now Yang is like, oi, but I don't get to murder no one. I'm sure the vegans will appreciate them. Their cow being destroyed. But hey, now hell, that's grass.
Ooh, someone's selling a pristine Dragon Warrior 4 here in Canada.
Oh,
Calgary.
No, it's gonna be at least 3 digits. At least.
So this price is Canadian.
$400 to $600.
Game manual charts plus manual $350.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's Canadian, so. And it's got one of those plastic boxes over it, you know?
Oh yeah.
Keep it good. Also restaurants that don't speak English are the best ones. Yeah. You know a restaurant is good if it has one of those old Pepsi signs, like Pepsi, like menu boards.
I'm trying to think if it was the oatmeal that had like the big town Chinese restaurant versus the small town Chinese restaurant. It's like the small town one's called like Diarrhea Dragon.
Oh wow, yeah, that Dragon Quest IV is pristine. Box is like, I see one scuff and that's it.
Oh,
alright,
Skunch.
Keep out with Skunch. Yep, Purge.
Rennet. Oh, I can make cheese. So that will be if I get rennet and milk, I'm guessing. It's either going to be butter
or
milk.
Let me look up rennet.
Well, so rennet is what you use to make cheese. It's like bacteria.
I'm checking. I know, I'm still checking. Oh yeah, fresh milk.
So yeah, that's how you make cheese on this. Hello.
The root of all evil.
Okay, so we're gonna have you psych up. Sam. Buff on Jessica. Alright. Is Bang better than Frizz?
Me at this point, just use. Get that defense down, you know?
Yeah.
Bang would do a little more damage, but it just costs more MP, so.
Helm. Why not? Alright, he's got a fair bit of health.
Yeah. Genghis is your tank. Genghis is your tankus. Oh, this guy, Root of Evil, yeah.
Hey.
Okay, I found the option, like, my ad manager to, like, change my button where, like, this is how long before your ad stopped. It was set to 1 minute and 50, like, a minute and a half.
Yeah.
I changed it to 3 minutes, so I can at least get that.
Yeah, so, like, I have, like, a minute 30 or, like, a 3 minute button I can press.
So I'd rather have, like, run 3 minutes of ads. And get like an hour break.
Yep.
For no ads. But I used to do it. Also, you don't have a sword, but nice little difference in that how like Skunch and Angelo attack with a sword.
Yeah.
You do a jumping slash, but he just does like
a lunge.
A running pierce, you know? Yeah, I love that.
He's very much a fencer.
Yeah.
Hot pockets.
I love when they at least do little small things to differentiate. Man, I'm looking at more of that Facebook thing where he's showing off his Dragon Warrior 4 and just looking at the monster chart that they have, and it's like, that's so cool how, like, you know, the older RPGs. Here's an extra chart of, like, all the spells and what they do. All the monsters and their stats, you know?
Yeah. Ooh, the town.
Hey.
Yeah, this is a bridge.
Oh, it could be just a bridge then.
Well, you can kind of see the castle on the by the coast.
Yeah, I see it. Oh, well, there you go. I was thinking about some dumb ways I like, you know, with like how, like, some people like, if I go back in time, I go do this, do that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I go, like, if I go back in time, I go buy games just when the store is about to get rid of them.
Oh, yeah, right. I'd get all the DS Dragon Quest.
But only the copies that don't get sold, because you gotta think about, like, if you bought this game and it was the game that someone was gonna buy. No. What?
Oh, it's the castle, Troad's castle, I imagine.
I think it was on the other continent.
Well.
Oh, check that house.
Yeah, something's up. God damn it, Gub.
But yeah, you buy the games when they're about to get rid of them, and like, you check to see if anyone ever buy that game. They don't? Well, buy it for when it's super cheap. That's the way I think. Mm-hmm. Or if I go back in time and wanted to start a business, I'd go start an arcade and use my knowledge if games are popular, you know?
Oh, use it for good.
Yeah, open up an arcade, but only get the games that I know are gonna be, like, certified fop. That's the way I think. Think about causality.
Granddaughter Emma works as a maid of the castle. She's a lovely, hardworking girl. She's not been able to take any holiday for the past 2 years now. I do miss her visits. Way to the castle, just follow the path to the east and you will come to it eventually.
Oh.
Oh, a heirloom.
The mantle that is in fact mini. So I used to remember my Zellers, which is like Target.
Mm-hmm.
My Zellers and Superstore just had like the used game bin that they would never get touched. And just think about the games that were like, you know, $20, you know? Oh yeah! Puppeteer. Look at him. But yeah, being able to pick up those games, you know, didn't sell ever. Game them for like nothing while they're still like shrink wrapped.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
It's easy to be like one of those people, like, I go back and buy like all the copies, like all these rare games. Like, oh, cool. You change the future. You change the past. Because what if someone bought those games naturally?
You now have all the copies, therefore they are worthless.
Yeah. The whole party's hallucinating. But say for me, I know for a fact that my Canadian Tire, for the longest time, just had a whole bunch of complete box copies of Final Fight CD.
Man.
That they couldn't get rid of. And they were selling for like nothing, and I wish I could have bought a couple copies. They're worth a lot now. But yeah, like, I knew eventually they probably just threw them away or something, but it's like, I could have bought all those. And they would have been like, finally, someone got rid of them.
Oh. Thought I heard the ding. Still cheeky safe.
Oh yeah, it was Groundhog's Day.
Oh yeah, it was yesterday, wasn't it? Or the day before?
Yeah, I think it was the day before. Which means Clay got affected by that. He lives there.
Uh-huh.
As he puts it, I want to kill that stupid groundhog.
Pucks it when he fell.
Yeah. She had fun doing Mario Party, and then she finished off with Soul Calibur yesterday, Kanan.
Hmm.
It was a... Ooh.
Angelo, you look like you've got the weight of the world on your shoulders.
Ten, ten, ten.
Maybe it would help to get it off your chest, hmm? Not that I want to force you, mind.
It'd be nice.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe things will never be right between us. Marcello will never forgive me. If only we didn't share common blood, I'm sure we'd get along fine.
He sounds like a craven douche, this Marcello.
Commander of the Templars. There we go. I think it had to load up the sepia tone.
Yep.
dad backstory time.
Francisco was always well known around these parts for his benevolence. He'd often take in children who had nowhere else to go.
Aw, look at little Angelo.
And I was one of them. My parents were well off, part of the aristocracy. But then they both died. All of a sudden, I was left with no family and no money. The Abbey was the only place I could go.
You're new here, aren't you? Are you here to join the brothers? Have you come all on your own? Oh, you must be exhausted. Where are your things? Is that all you've got?
Is this like an... Is this a whole thing we could have accidentally skipped?
Yeah.
My mummy and daddy died. So I don't have many things, and I don't have anywhere else to go.
You sound a lot like me. But there's no need to worry. Abbot Francisco and all of us will be your family from now on.
But...
Let's go and find the abbot. Come on now, don't cry. Why don't you tell me your name?
Angelo.
I don't like that name.
You don't know how right you were.
You! So you're Angelo.
Huh.
Leave. I want you to leave. You leave and never come back. I don't ever want to see you again. So you're intent on ruining this life for me as well, are you?
Huh.
Yep.
Marcello was the golden boy of the Abbey. He studied hard and had a bright future ahead of him. But when it came to me, his attitude wasn't so positive.
I'm so sorry, child. I'm sad to say I heard that little exchange.
You're a little bitch, aren't you, Angel?
It's so unlike Marcello to act like that. I just don't understand. Ah... I see. I always knew he had a half-brother. That's you, isn't it? You're Angelo. Well, they say time heals all wounds. Let's hope your living here will make everything all right. Now, come along with me. From today onwards, this will be your home. Why don't I introduce you to everyone?
Not long after that, I heard the full story for the first time. About how I had a half-brother who was born from an affair between my father and one of the maids.
There you go.
Yep.
And that was Marcello. If I hadn't been born, he'd have been next in line to my father. But when I was born, Marcello and his mother were thrown out of the house with nothing to their names. She died soon afterwards. He had no one. So he ended up at the Abbey, hating me and my father for all those years.
Man, that sucks.
Quite a bombshell, don't you think? I was so young and innocent then, too. The whole thing hurt more than you can imagine. Still, c'est la vie. My father got off lightly. He did just what he wanted and then died, and left me to take the consequences. I'm the only one left for Marcello to hate now. In a way, I can't say I blame him, and it was probably good that we lived together. At least it gave him someone. Certainly added a bit of spice to the humdrum life at Maiella Abbey, anyway.
Angelo, I'm so...
This story's gone on long enough. Look, it's nearly daybreak.
With that...
Wait!
Can't tell how Angelo ended up the way he was.
Damn.
Yep. They're not afraid to really flesh out the support, like, the characters in this one.
At least it doesn't take an entire fucking game to learn about one of the characters. Like, in six.
And it's even better with the voice acting.
Yep.
That's just little Angelo and how innocently adorable his voice is. You're like... I want 10 of them.
Little brother.
Little brother. The heart of a champion. But yeah, you're pretty much like, oh, free in? You might as well stay here, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, hey, story. I don't remember what the deal with this kingdom was.
I guess we'll find out.
A bow.
He's tough. Okay. There it is. Hey, Slime Knights, Healy.
This is an awful team to fight.
Right, because they can all heal.
Go ham, you got lots of MP, just healed up.
Yeah.
Funny thing, I get email like, "Yeah, tell us when Bill is ready. Tell us if my old provider's like, wait, what? I canceled my phone bill. Your bill is $4. So the fact I'm still getting automated like phone bills, but they're for nothing, like, wow.
It's like my toll tag.
Like, yeah,
it's just stuck in limbo because it's not being used. So I'll get these bills for $0. There's not like a please close my account option. But I need to find a way to do that so I can at least get the $20 back.
Okay. Nope, tension does not work when using items. That's right, you're gonna heal, it's kinda better to use like, and you tension up.
Yeah.
It's kinda better to use like, an item. It didn't help that Hot Pocket was done right before battle, so...
Yeah, I need to check that out.
Hot Pocket.
Just spells...
Ooh. So I found the Twitter for one of the people working on the new Metal Slug, spiritual successor.
Oh, yeah.
And he showed off, like, one of the animations he did in it. Black Finger Jet. Ugh. We'll have to try and get on Fortnite next week because the turtles event that's happening.
Oh. Huh.
Yeah. I wonder if we're gonna get like Shredder and maybe Splinter. That'd be cool.
That would be cool.
He's a radical rat. Yeah, look at that. You got your awesome party now.
Oh yeah. Hey, level up Flangelo.
Not a great level.
Tingle.
Tingle. That helps with paralysis. So just put that in bow for now. Yeah, you can go for like, see what they do. There's my thing. But yeah, bows are honestly just amazing. And he can still use a shield while using a bow. You have a leather shield you can totally give him too.
Oh, right, yeah.
Yeah, that would help this man. I like how that cheese just has blue on it on the top.
It's a cool cheese. Slime line.
You gotta make sure to see that every time she uses an item, they bounce.
Bouncing everywhere.
They're almost there. The only thing I wish is that there was it would just automate this, you know?
Yeah.
But it is what it is. Okay, that's what the next town is. Cool. Double checking what it is.
There's our next enemy.
Cow?
Yeah. Oh.
Well, you can make some more cheese.
Yep. Well, once the mega hub is done. Well, that's cool.
Yeah.
Now we know where to get that.
I have a suggestion. Why don't you try out your new cheese?
Yeah, when... I think it's in the bag, though.
Oh, great. That's fine. Next one. No. There it is. One Munchie's Papers. Yeah, cheese makes Munchie do a breath attack.
That's cool.
I guess it just, like, riles him up, you know?
Yeah.
Gives him the energy he needs.
Just
and you know what? You're right. That was cool. A cool breath attack.
Hello, other cow. Hello, other cow.
Well, that's a good thing all these cows are like have babies that they can give this milk to, because that's totally how it works, right?
Yep.
And not just every cow can give you milk just because they can give you milk. That's basically that really good water that heals you for a lot.
Okay.
Arma de Essos. Remember that town in Dragon Quest VI that had like the super cool, the super nice water?
Uh-huh.
That's basically that.
Oh, okay.
I think that's what it was called in the, when it came over here. Yeah, now you got a full party, you're starting to get some synergy. Synergy. I'm just thinking from the old Dilbert cartoon where someone would just say synergy and people would be like, oh. New town. Where are the equipment shops at?
Have I heard of a jester named Dulmavis? Ha! As if a jester would come to a gloomy old place like this. Look around you, everyone's here is dressed in black. If Jester had been here,
He'd have stood out like a sore thumb.
I think something happened.
Yeah.
Oh, you are one of them. Hey, a bow! And dagger.
Wow, that's worse than my...
Yeah, so you got something even better.
Damn. Alright.
It's only... That little broadsword's only slightly better than your boomerang. Oh, it's a Weird Al song. Oh, there you go.
What? Wait, what?
What?
Oh, the synergy song, that's right. Actually.
There you go. Oh, that's cool, I guess. Oh, hey, hello, I guess. So we have leather dress, bronze armor, and iron cutlass. I think Angela's fine.
Yeah.
Oh, his defense sucks, though. Might need to get him, like, a scale shield or something. Someone else, but, you can either get, something... You can either spend it all on that iron cutlass...
I can get the bronze shield to Yangus and then give Yangus's scale shield to...
And then buy the leather dress for Jessica, just so she can give her a little extra defense on top.
Yeah.
Because you can afford both. Can I help you with anything else, I guess? All right then, I'll catch you later.
Just hear
I guess.
Bang.
Yeah, he's got all of his Templar stuff on, so he's fine. Fancy like that. He put some herbs in Yang's thing, and don't forget he can heal too. Put his sword away. And yeah, just the differences, because, like, I don't think Angelo can use the big swords, like, he can't use that, the broadsword. Because he prefers different types of swords. Those things like that.
Yeah. There we go.
Yeah, bye, I'm gonna make it quick.
Oh, look.
Where's that powder? How convenient and cheap. How much milk did you get? Oh, yeah, just buy it.
Oh, oops. King and Queen often used to sit and talk in the park in front of our inn. They were such a wonderful couple. So good together. All right.
Guessing something bad happened. The bad thing.
The event.
The badening.
They became badniks.
I remember when I was watching this, like, so this is basically video for, like, a draft for Fire Emblem. One day, humans and dragons were cool, and then Ladies Ring.
Oops.
And then suddenly, the bad thing happened. And the dragons were like, screw you, humans. Let's leave it in there. We'll probably be able to... Probably someone lost it. And most likely. Yeah. Like, no, where did my ring go? I just had it. It's really expensive, you know.
Oh boy.
Well then.
Graveside.
What's the theme of this town?
Hot pockets. Everyday hot pockets. All right, so we want...
The theme of this town is Hot Pockets, indeed, Gerb.
Yep. Where did we have the bag of granite? If only King would get better again. It's only been 2 years now, and all we have to wear, and we all have to wear mourning clothes, and everyone's so gloomy. It's unbearable.
I don't think you mourn for like 2 years.
Yeah.
Thing.
This has the stink of dual mages on it.
Mummy, I'm tired of wearing black. Well, tough.
I'm fed up with always being indoors. I want to go and play outside. Well, no, you can't.
I have vitamin C deficiency, don't I? It wasn't C for sun, or D?
D.
Yeah. Vitamin D deficiency.
D, yeah. Oh, no. See, didn't quite get over the death of his wife, got it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Queen was so intelligent and level-headed. She was a pillar of strength for the king. I'm sure if she could see him now, she'd tell him to put himself together. Yay, you got clipped.
Pocket.
We are nearing.
Yeah. I mean, it was kind of perfect timing.
Yeah. Black cloth covering the castle is there to show that we're all sad. That's why we're dressed like this, too. We haven't been allowed to wear anything but black for 2 whole years, though.
Everyone must be goth. I've been going for the TV tropes again, trying to look at all the old stuff. This.
Oh, here we go.
Talked about cheese.
This is where it tells us how to make cheese. You can make your own cheese. All you have to do is combine rennet powder with fresh milk. If you're fortunate enough to have access to an alchemy pot, simply put the ingredients into the pot and start cooking. In fact, you can make a whole variety of cheeses in an alchemy pot. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. Every journey begins with a single step. Practice with the recipe for plain cheese first. Yeah. G'day, curd nerds.
I just love on here, it's like, spoilers. Even more spoilers. Stop looking in here, there's spoilers. TV Tropes character page.
God. Tale of Ascanthia. Luna in the sky, on the nights of the full moon, I shall try. If in the right places I do sit, a door is revealed by the light you emit. Oh.
This sounds important.
On the highest hilltop I shall search, waiting in my mountaintop perch. The magic doorway shines so bright, but only on a full moon's night. Through the portal your dreams lie, would you try it? You would try it if you were so wise. Not a great end rhyme, but It sounds like a thing that'll only show up on the top of a mountain at night, then. Interesting. Leatherworking and introduction. Fur poncho is an invaluable garment. It protects the wearer from both heat and cold. It's also durable and lasts a long time.
Ooh.
Studies indicate that they can be created by combining two kinds of animal skin in some way.
So, animal pelts, so maybe that magic leather that we have?
Yeah.
Yeah, I could two of those, maybe.
Great rocks. It may look silly, but take it from me, a stone hard hat is a great way to protect your noggin. They're easy to make too, all you have to do is combine a stone axe and a certain kind of hat. Believe me, it's worth the time it takes to cook one up.
Certain kind of hat, huh? Oh, we need to get another axe first, but we'll save that stone axe.
Yeah. The Cow Whisperer. The Daily Encyclopedia and the Grass Grazing Introduction. So they're a farming town, clearly.
I think this is a good saving point.
Yeah.
Every night the sound of the king's sobbing plunges the country deeper into misery. Those left behind suffer so much, the souls of the dead can't rise to heaven. Hang on. You're safe.
That's so sad. So very, very sad.
Sorry for your loss, whatever. Could be safe, please. So sad.
This song is called I'm So Sad, So Very, Very Sad. Yes.
But, thank you for stopping in with us. We'll be back next week with an episode. I'll be back this afternoon at 4 p.m. Central for Translator's Night with Kevin Frame, where we are still going through Machi with Hanako and Midori.
There you go. Those wacky girls. Face peoples. Peoples? Yarples?
Girls? But, yeah. Thank you all for stopping in, and we'll see you next time.